Good morning, dear students. Today we will discuss about the philosophy eclecticism. Eclecticism, this term is new for all of you. And one more thing I wanted to add is there are different philosophies and every day new philosophies are emerging. But in your syllabus only idealism, naturalism, pragmatism and eclecticism is given. That's why we are restricting our classes into these four philosophies. So today we will be discussing about eclecticism in detail. So there is no philosophy which meets the entire requirements. So we have taken one parallel experience in the previous class and we have tried for some common agreement points which you feel it is significant for our life of or our philosophy of life. So in that itself it's very clear, no philosophy meets the entire requirements. So some points may be taken from one philosophy and another point will be taken from another philosophy. So accepting a philosophy individually is not easy for everybody. Some may be liking the moral values, some may not be liking the spiritual power, accepting the spiritual power, some may not be liking the activity orientation. So a single philosophy which meets the demands of everybody is not easy, or it is not the. So what we have done in eclecticism is the synthesis of positive points of other philosophies. So we have taken different philosophies and we will be synthesizing a new philosophy by taking the positive points from various philosophies. So here only positive points are added and this can be accepted as a philosophy for their life. The eclectic tendency in education, that means the meaning is attempt to synthesize or to select and draw together the ideas and aspects from different philosophies. So we are taking out the positive points from various philosophies and we are trying to make a new one. So synthesize or to select and draw together the ideas and aspects from different philosophies. We are making a new one. We are synthesizing by selecting or drawing together the ideas, aspects from different philosophies. So that is the eclecticism. So we are making everything in a new pot and mixing it. So we are taking different points from various philosophy and we are making in a, by mixing the positive points from various philosophies and mixing together to make a new philosophy. So this is known as the eclecticism. So the meaning, that is fusion or synthesis of different philosophies of education. So this is the synthesis or fusion of different philosophies of education. And in another way we can say that harmonization of principles underlying various tendencies and rationalization of educational practices. So we are seeing the usefulness in educational practices and we are trying to use the various philosophies or their principles in a new philosophy, or we are trying to make a new one with the different concepts of different philosophies. So putting together of common views, so they will be analyzing what are the common points or the common views which is finding positive or finding useful, and they are making a new one, putting together of common views. So we are trying to make a new philosophy from taking points from various philosophies. So the definition of eclecticism, that is synthesis or harmonious blend of the diverse philosophies of education. It is a process of pulling out and putting together the useful and essential aspects of the various philosophies of education. Hope you are clear. So we are just trying pulling out and putting together the useful and essential aspects of various philosophies of education into a new one. This is the definition. One more definition according to Monroe, that is, the eclectic tendency is that which seeks the harmonization of principles underlying various tendencies and rationalization of educational process or educational practices. So we are trying to make a reason for what we are doing in that particular education. So this reasoning is done with the help of useful concepts, useful principles from various philosophies. So this is according to Monroe. Next, we can see why we have to have eclecticism. What is the need of eclecticism? So there are different philosophies. Why we want to make a new one by taking new things or positive things from various philosophy? What is the need of eclecticism? Why we want to do this much work on a new philosophy? Because already there are different philosophies. So the first point is, no philosophy is complete and applied in all situations. So idealism has its own positive points, but it cannot be applied in all situations. Naturalism also has positive points, but alone naturalism cannot explain all parts of education or all parts of our life. So no philosophy is complete and applied in all situations. It's the first need of eclecticism. To channelize and utilize the abilities and talents of the youth. So in many of the philosophies, they underestimate or they are not giving chances for showing the talents, abilities of the youth. So to meet that, we have to use a new philosophy. The next one, to meet changing needs and demands in the world. So there are changes occurs in your environment, in the world, economic status, socioeconomically or environmental changes, everything happens in the world, disease pattern, everything is changing. So the demands are high and we want to meet these needs and demands in the world. So we should have a new philosophy with positive points. To promote good citizenship. So many of the philosophies are not indicating the social relationship, the democracy, everything. So we have to have a good citizenship among the citizens. So that is another need of eclecticism in general. So why or what is the need for eclecticism in India? So when you're talking about our country, what is the need of eclecticism in our country? So the first one is cultural diversity. So our cultural background, it is that much unique, that is, it is diverse in nature, according to the states, according to the color, according to the cultural background, according to the religion, according to the our customs, according to our practices, everywhere different, there is wide and diversity exist. So we should have a new philosophy with satisfaction or which satisfies the needs of these diversified community. So that is a first point, that is regarding the cultural diversity. The second is democratic ideals in India. So many of the philosophies are not supporting democracy, equal importance for all members in the society. So we have a democratic nation and we have to propagate our ideals, that is democratic ideals. That is the second need for eclecticism. And movement from agriculture to industrial and electronic revolution. So initially it was agriculture, and now it is changing. The revolution is happening in agriculture and it is changing into electronic and industrial world. So these changes should support, or these changes should be met with one single philosophy. So that is the next point why we need eclecticism in India. The next one is presence of rigid educational pockets, especially religious institutions. So this is what we are discussing, or we have to imagine the situation of just post-independence period. During that time, the educational institutions were, majority of the educational institutions were run by religious institutions, and they were given training on the religion. So we should have a separate education system which contains every aspects of our nation than religion. That was need of that particular period. So rigid educational pockets, especially religious institutions, that government or our country wanted to change. So these were the need for eclecticism in India. So this eclecticism in India, especially during the post-independence period. So next we can see some of the common points of agreements which this eclectic philosophers find in their studies. The first common point of agreement is respect for child's personality keeps child in the center of educational system. So we have seen in naturalism, so the center of the educational system is the child or the student. They should be given the chance to select their subject, and the student is given more importance than the teacher. So respect for child's personality, child's needs should be met. This is the first common point of agreement, because in modern education we give importance to the child than anybody. The next is powerful force of mind and intellect. So in idealism, we were given importance that our mind is more powerful. We can imagine, we can have thoughts, and we can find out our own knowledge. So this was accepted, like powerful mind of force of mind and intellect. So mind is powerful, our intelligence is powerful. That is also the second common point of agreement. The third one is self-discipline. So they were accepted from the pragmatism, that is, like, they were believing that if the person is self-disciplined, there will be social discipline, and ultimately the nation will be progressing. So this was the another common point of agreement. Individual and social development. So in pragmatism, this was focusing. So the child should be developed through proper educational system. So when the individual is developed, ultimately it is developing the society. So that is the individual and social development. Then the next is the curriculum, that is life-centered curriculum, like languages, mathematics, science, history, geography, etc. should be taken into consideration. And interest and motivation of the child. So whenever we are talking about the educational system or teaching learning activities, the interest and the motivation of the child is very much important. So these are the some of the common points of agreement. Okay, and based on these common points of agreement, the eclectic philosophy was emerged, and the aim of education in eclecticism. Education should give a child a command of basic process of learning. So the basic process of learning, the child should get a command as a aim of education. So there should be an inner command the child has to learn by himself. The second point is child should become an efficient member of the society. Next point is aim of education is good health. So aim of education, is focusing on the healthy hygienic practices which keeps the person healthy. Skillful training, so they give importance for learning by doing, for increasing the skill of the person. The next is development of good character. So they accepts the importance of moral character, ethical values or values and other things which makes a person's character good. So these are the some of the aims of education, and we will see the other aims are to prepare the person to take his place in life. So he should be able to find his place in his life and should be able to lead a successful life. Next is interest and motivation of the child has to improve. Interest and motivation of the child has to improve to be able to think, reason and adapt himself to his environment. To be able to think, reason and adapt himself to his environment. So he has to find out new things. He has to have reasoning and he has to adapt himself. That means he has to adjust with his environment. So these are the some of the aims of education according to eclecticism. So we have seen that aims of education include: education should give a child a command of basic process of learning. Child should become an efficient member of society. Good health, skillful training, development of good character, to prepare the person to take his place in life, interest and motivation of the child has to improve, to be able to think, reason and adapt himself to his environment. So these are the aims of education in eclecticism. Next is curriculum, that is life-centered curriculum. So they were focusing on the curriculum which helps the person to lead a successful life. So he should know the languages, he should have a basic knowledge regarding the geography, history, mathematics and various languages, so that he can lead a successful life. So this is the life-centered curriculum. Method of teaching, they were advocating playway method, so that without compulsion the learning happens and children will be more easily get involved in learning when we are adopting playway method. Learning by doing, so the skill training is given importance in aims of education in eclecticism. So they have to practice learning by doing. Then direct experiences, so the projects, problem solving methods, etc. they have to adopt. So these are the method of teaching according to eclecticism. The role of teacher, here they emphasize teacher training, because in idealism we were considering that as a great philosopher automatically he becomes a teacher, or the person who has done his tedious works to see God as the teacher. So now in eclecticism they tell that they emphasize that simply a person cannot become a teacher, there should be a proper training. So a prescribed period of time should be there for training the students, training the teachers. Like teachers training program, B.Ed or M.Ed, this training should be undergone. So that is about the teacher training, emphasize the teacher training, and teacher need to be prepared. They understand the importance of teacher training and they emphasize the need of that. So that is about the role of teacher. A person is not making or becoming teacher simply. There should be a proper education, and after the basic education he or she undergo training. The next discipline, what they like is self-discipline. So they believe that when the person is disciplined self, it leads to cooperative acts in the society, which leads to the social discipline, so that it leads to the national discipline. So that is ultimately the growth of the society happens when the individuals are with self-discipline. So this is about the eclecticism, and we know that we are bringing positive points from various philosophies. So only positives are there. The weaknesses are not there in eclecticism. So only positive points are taken from various philosophies. So hope you all understood what is eclecticism and the details of eclecticism. So write down the notes and study well. Thank you very much.